What's up guys? Have you always dreamed of unlocking the planche? Then you have to start with the fundamentals. In this video, I will share the most efficient way to unlock the tucked planche from home. So the planche is one of the hardest skills to unlock in calisthenics. It asks for a tremendous amount of shoulder strength and requires long-term dedication. At this moment, you might be stuck at home or you don't have access to a gym. But that doesn't mean you cannot start with training the planche. In fact, your home environment is the perfect place to start with planche training because the only thing that you need to start is a chair. When it comes to my own experience with the planche, I can fairly say that I have a love-hate relationship with this skill. I started with the basics like tucked and negatives, then worked up to a straddle, then got injured by simply overtraining and wanting the results too fast. I gotta be honest on that. After that, I did a lot of rehab work and started with skill training again until I achieved a straddle planche push-up. So I really want to emphasize the importance of the basic strength for this skill, which definitely starts with the tucked planche. So today I will get into three different phases with certain exercises and a routine per level that you should be doing to unlock the tucked planche. So let's get into the first part and make sure to watch the video till the end for our weekly giveaway and make sure to subscribe for more calisthenics gains. In the first phase, your strength requirement is at least 10 push-ups. If you cannot do 10 push-ups yet, there is no reason to consider starting with the planche and you should be first working on the basics. In the first phase, the goal is to get strong in basic shoulder strength. Therefore, the goal of the first phase is 10 pike push-ups, because this exercise lays the foundation of solid shoulder strength. The following exercises are the best exercises that you can do from home to work to this goal. So let's get into the exercises. As you can see from the exercises, they are all quite basic, but necessary to master. Since you are still in the beginning of your fitness or calisthenics journey, we recommend to train 2 times per week and use the following routine. First, start off with the harder exercises with each workout, like the pike push-ups or negative pike push-ups, and gradually lower the difficulty and perform higher reps with the easier exercises until you're able to perform your first 10 pike push-ups with good form. Until now, you have been working on fundamental exercises to prepare for the tucked planche. These exercises were all bent arm exercises, whereas the muscle fibers shorten and lengthen, and whereas the position of the elbow joint changes. The tucked planche, however, is a straight arm exercise, where the angle of the elbow joint stays in the same position while the muscle fibers generating isometric strength. Therefore, you should incorporate straight arm exercises in the second phase. So a nice goal to work towards is a 10-second L-sit hold. The following exercises are the best exercises that you can do from home to work on the 10-second L-sit hold. So let's get into the exercises. We'll be right back. All right, so these are the exercises that you should be doing to prepare for straight arm strength. Since these exercises are more technique-based than strength-related, you can try this 3 times per week, like one day on and one day off. For example, you can alternate between high and low intensity days, in which you work on the harder progressions on the first workout and the easier variations on the second workout. Repeat this sequence until you're able to hold your first 10-second L-sit hold. All right, so now it's game time. You have built enough basic shoulder strength in the first phase and enough scapula and straight arm strength in the second phase. To unlock the tuck planche, we're gradually going to work to the position of the tuck planche by using both dynamic straight arm exercises and similar positions of the tuck planche. So let's get into the exercises. So these are some of the best exercises to work towards the tucked planche. I've done these myself in the beginning a lot. In this phase, you should train these exercises 3 times per week to see optimal results. Frequency is key here. A good method to train these exercises is to switch between static and dynamic trainings. For example, training 1 is static training, training 2 is dynamic training, and so on, until you can hold your first 10-second tucked planche hold. Congratulations. All right, so these were the 3 phases with goals that you have to work on to unlock your tucked planche. I hope this video was helpful, and if it was, please like this video because it will really help us to grow this channel. 2 weeks back, we introduced our new weekly giveaways. And of course, we want to help you out to start with the planche. So the perfect piece of equipment are wrist wraps to support your wrist. So therefore, we will give away 1 pair of our new Calisthenics Family exclusive wrist wraps. How to win? Like this video, subscribe to our channel, and comment within the first 24 hours. The winner will be announced in the next video, so make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out. Last video, we gave away our full pack of resistance bands, and the winning comment will appear right here. Congrats. And by the way, this is the first time that we show these wrist wraps, and we have also just launched these in our wrap shop, so make sure to check them out. So guys, thanks for watching, and if you're new to calisthenics, make sure to download our free workouts and free ebooks to get yourself started in a safe and effective way. And if you really want to bring your training results to the next level, make sure to start a full journey workout plan in which we teach you several skills step by step while you work on your physique and strength. So thanks for watching, and we will see you in the next video on Monday. Peace out.